Welcome to another NUCIDA video. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time. I will introduce TestRail, a powerful test management tool used by testers and developers worldwide to organize and manage their testing efforts more efficiently. By choosing TestRail, you unlock a key ingredient to help you prepare your recipe for success. In this tutorial series, you'll learn the basics of TestRail, from documenting your test cases, plans, and runs to capturing real-time results and generating meaningful reports. If your team is new to TestRail, we highly recommend forwarding this training video to all your team members. Please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell, never to forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. All right, let's get started. In this video tutorial, I'm going to walk you through how to execute your Cypress automated test project, to integrate with the TestRail CLI and upload your test results to TestRail. All these in just a couple of lines in your terminal. Let's jump straight to our script. As you can see, our script is very small. It only has 5 steps and all of them are quite straightforward. The first step is to install your test project, and you do so by using npm install, which is how you install a Cypress project. I'm going to run that in my terminal, and in just a couple of seconds, I'll be able to gather all the packages required to run Cypress, and there we go. All the packages have been downloaded and added to the project before running the Cypress test using the line on the second command. We are going to open Cypress itself and see on the UI what these tests are all about. We just write npx cypress open on our terminal. It should open the Cypress UI, and there we go. We can see that we have an end-to-end testing project configured. Let's open that. I'm going to select Chrome and start end-to-end testing in Chrome. The Chrome instance is now opening where we can run our Cypress tests and see that it found 2 test suites, todo interactions, and todo smoke. Let's try out one of them just to see the results. So it's going to run a couple of tests and we can see it running on the main panel. The third test is now running. We can see all the logs, etc. 2 tests are passed, and 1 is failed. This is what our test project is doing, and we can see how it is displayed in the results. Now, let's close this and go back to our command line. Usually, running tests through the UI is good for debugging purposes for creating your tests. But when you are executing your tests in a pipeline, etc., you want to run them using a command line. To do that, you can just use the Cypress run command. So, you would do npx cypress run, and then to integrate with the TestRail CLI, we just need a couple of options, which is the reporter. Because the TestRail CLI requires a unit report, and Cypress provides one out of the box. Thus, you just need to pass the reporter option using the unit value, and then some reporter options to configure the mentioned reporter feature. In this case, what you need to know is that we need to use this hash placeholder here, because this will make it so that each test suite will generate an individual report and not overwrite the report every time a new test suite is executed. Let's run this command and see what happens. Now Cypress is starting and it's making a couple of checks, no worries here. It's now starting to run our tests to do some interactions. We have 3 tests over there. One of them was failing, so that's why it takes a little longer too. It took 7 seconds. All good so far. Now it executed the second test suite, and we can see that on todo interaction, we have 2 tests that are passed, 1 that failed. Concerning the todo smoke, we only had 1 test, and it passed. It generated some reports. These reports follow the unit standard, which is supported by the TestRail CLI, to upload the test results to TestRail. Let's look at one of them. This is for interactions, like we can see here in the interaction suite, and we can see that we have 1 test case here, that passed because it doesn't have any inner element, another one that passed, and then we have this test case that failed because it has a failure element in it. Now, we are going to take the TestRail CLI. First, we need to install the TestRail CLI, or in short, TRCLI, and we can do that with this command. It requires Python to be installed on your machine, and we recommend Python 3.10 or above. Now it's installed, and we are going to use this next command, unitparser, to merge the reports. So, we use this glob pattern to find the reports that are in the folder reports, and their file names start with unit. Let's just run this, and it very quickly compiles the reports to unitreport.xml, which contains both the smoke tests and the interactions tests. This is the generated report we want to upload with the TestRail CLI. To upload it with the TestRail CLI, we just need to use this last command. This command is in multiple lines, just to be easier to read. But what we have here is a call to the TestRail CLI. Then we are using the hyphen Y option. This option makes the TestRail CLI create all entities for you. We are using a code-first approach where all tests from your automated test project will be automatically created in TestRail, and the results will be submitted. Please watch our other tutorial videos explaining the code-first and specification-first approach, besides of other TRCLI details that are very helpful. The first thing you have to do is set your instance details. In this case, the hyphen H means host, and you add your host here, and then the U for user, we have our user email here, and then P for password. We recommend you generate an API token instead of using your password directly, but for this purpose, this is good enough. Then define the project you want to submit your results to. In this case, we have set up this project, and then you send the parameter parseUnit. We use the F option, where you define the path to your report, the report that has the results that you want to upload, and finally a title for your test run. This is a very basic example. There are more options you can use in the TestRail CLI, just check the help and the documentation. Then you'll be able to do a lot more than this. But for now, let's just execute this. And we can see that the TestRail CLI found 4 test cases in 2 sections. It's now checking the project, it checked the project successfully, and it will now create the test cases and upload their results. To use this code-first approach, you need to set up your TestRail project to have a custom field that is named Automation ID. You can find information about how to do that in our other TestRail video tutorials. We can see that the test run was created, the results were added, and we have a very convenient link here. So, we can go straight to our instance and see the results there. But let's first come here and see the test cases in our TestRail instance. We didn't have any test cases, and now we have a couple of test cases for the smoke test suite and the interaction suite. These test cases were automatically created, and if we expand the test, we can see that they have the attribute automation ID. This automation ID is made by the name and the class name on the report, so it will match each test case and the class name. The class name here plus the name here actually class name dot name. And so we have our tests here. Therefore, the TRCLI is able to map the tests, and it created a run using these tests. We can see that we have our separate automated tests, like we specified in the title, and if we open them, we can see the test results. So we see that for the smoke test suite, the test passed, and on the interaction test suite, one of the tests failed. If we click on the arrow here, we can see the error message that is translated from the report to the results. So, you can more easily debug what happened, but you will likely have to also debug the test through the Cypress UI. This is how you integrate your Cypress tests with TestRail using the TestRail CLI in just a couple of lines in your terminal. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell, never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time, or even produce a separate video about your topic. Please also check out our other over 200 videos about software quality. Happy testing. See you next time.